Hello, welcome back everyone. Let's continue on. Where am I going? I don't think this is my... This isn't my house. And there's a phone call. Open the door. Alright, okay. He knows where I am again. Who is this guy? I'll give it my best shot, but I don't know. I wrote something down. Let's have a little read. Ah, right. The factory offices. That's where I am. All the suggestions of a large workforce, yet no actual signs of life. It is every bit as if someone has attempted to carefully create the illusion of a working factory complex. Yet this facade, when examined closely, is clearly just a falsification. But I must put aside my anxieties, quell the unease that pits my stomach, and continue on my path. Yes. There are invisible kids to find, after all. Okay, these are just tables, right? Not desks, and I can't open that. Fucking pig masks. God damn it. It's getting just strange. Oh, this is a desk. Ah, what we got here? Oh, it's just this diagram again. I saw this on the table earlier. Let's have a look inside this desk before we go any further. What's in here? Not a lot. Okay. Middle drawer. Ah! Is that... Yes, that's something to read. It's a diary entry. May the 1st, 1899. But then, what if they could stand upright and walk as men? What if the brute were harnessed thus? Would they sing? Would they find their own god? I have seen these things, and I will tell you now, no, they will not. But they will happily accept fealty to a god thrust upon them, and worship it thus given. In this, I realized, they are no different to the masses. They are much the same as us. Once this irrevocable threshold is passed, I understand that we too are shackled and must be set free. To free the man, we cut the man. In order to cross that great evolutionary line, it must be painted upon the ground. Hmm. And finally... Nope, just a spare shirt. Right. Should probably be keeping the lights on, to be honest. Right, let's get this chair out of the way. Is this door going to open? Yes! Okay, and this one over here? Yeah, this one as well. What is this I'm hearing? Is it that thing? Can I turn that off? That's a bit disturbing, really. I think it's jammed. Although, I think it's just finished. Typical. Alright, let's examine this desk as well. In here. Not a lot. In here. Whoa! Glasses and teeth. Shit. That's a strange reaction. It's like I was getting pulled up to the ceiling. Oh, there's something else to read down here as well. It's another diary entry. August 22nd, 1899. In America, they talk of building their cities to the skies. To me, this seems folly. But perhaps it is simply a case of a nation founded without a history of its own. We walk upon our histories. They are compacted in the very loam beneath our feet. The engineers we employed talked of this. They talked of how, when building the underground trains, they would often come across older tunnels crisscrossing the capital. What palaces lie buried beneath us? We are digging, digging, excavating and reappropriating what we find. At the center of the planet, my architect tells me, there is a great iron ball. It is the egg of the world. What an egg. What an egg it would be. I must have seen this like 10 times now. Right, so, unless I'm mistaken, there is nothing else here. And I will leave. I will leave through this door that goes into some sort of corridor. What have we got in here? Door's open. Tis a bathroom, good sir. And for some remarkable reason, I have no use for it. I haven't even soiled myself. Uh-huh. Going outside again. certainly a very big place. Now, there's something else to read down here, I see. It's just the wind. Just the wind. Okay, October the 11th, 1899. We integrate the very latest knowledge of chemistry, using low levels of a laudanum derivative to feed, to subdue the product even before the initiation of the process. This means that when we drag them from holding pens onto the line, they are less likely to panic and damage machine components, other products, or themselves. This section of the belt is sheathed in rubber and kept well lit to maintain good spirits, and we have actually found that the intelligent placement of gramophones and simple acoustic amplification tubes around the line, we can use music to further soothe the product. We find WC particularly effective in this regard. Was that what I was listening to earlier? That bizarre sort of music? Could be. Could be. What do we got? Warning, fuel pumps. Volatile chemicals are in use. These materials are highly corrosive. Wear protection. Always keep a condom on you. Right. Oh, look at those pigs. They are pigs, right? I think so. Let's get down here. Try this door. It is locked. Yep. Ah. Oh, I can pick one up. I can pick up an entire pig with one hand and shake it about. I am a strong man. Let's face it. Let's just put the pig back up here. There we go. It's the same thing again. What about this door? Also locked. And there is a third one down here. This one is unlocked. Oh, pigs on hooks. Excellent. Before I go through, let's just explore this room. I feel that there might be something I'm missing in here. There's a cart full of pigs. These ones I can't pick up. What's on the table? A few tools. A truck fueling station. Okay, and I've noted something down in the book. Pumping station. It appears to be some kind of fueling station. I have seen automobiles demonstrated at Mr. Miaham and Mr. Simmons' works. But the smell here is all wrong. This is not petroleum. Of that I am sure. Everything suggests to me that this machine must be significant in some way. Okay. Well, I must have a look at it then. It's a truck fueling station. There appears to be some sort of liquid in here. Let's try turning it on. Nope, not happening. Maybe if I put something there, it might work. Or what? No, I think if I put something there, it might work. So, what would go... I don't like these sounds, man. Oh! Oh, I can open these doors! Oh, it sort of is open already. Oh, it goes outside. Okay. But this seems to be blocking. Now, can I pull this towards me? No. Alright, I came through there, didn't I? This is unfortunately in the way. I should be able to push it away, really, but I can't. Shit. Right. Let's go through here now, then. Just keeping my eye out for a container for that fuel. Whoa! Did I knock that? I don't think I did. It can't be alive. There's a hook going through its head. And I very faintly hear the sound of a child crying through this door, but fuck, I cannot get through. This one I can. What have we here then? Is this my way out, possibly? Yes, yes, I think this will do. But before I do go out, let's try this door. Something else to read down here. Okay, September the 28th, 1899. Imagine, they say, a machine one day that might think like a man. As if this is to be desired. One might almost boast of creating a man who breeds like a pig. men and women upon all fours, rutting carelessly, ejaculating their filthy little missives onto the streets. Alleys and gutters running freely with the careless spill of their conjoinings. The air thick with the whimperings of lust. Bodies streaked with their own emissions. We have created a world where man is so utterly debased he will spray his seed over passers-by, and yet, this is the condition Babbage aspired to. No, this is not the machine we seek. Such an entity should be nothing less than a deity, and we would fall upon our knees and worship it. We shall not carve gods to bicker and fornicate. They will exist to clean the world and set us free. I reject Babbage as I reject these men of government. Let the pigs copulate in the gutters whilst they can. We shall scoop them up and ease their ascension soon enough. Now I'm just wondering, is there something up here? I like climbing on things. There is not. But I enjoyed it anyway. Let's get down here. And I think I'm going through the window now. If I can fit, I can. I'm out. And it seems like I'm the only one out here. And this will be the double doors. Can I move this out of the way now? Yeah, I can. Excellent. Let's get this over. Yeah, here we'll do, I guess. Alright. Swing this open a little bit more. Alright. Now, this is clearly important, but I don't have a container. Anything over here? Nothing hiding behind the boxes or anything? No. Okay. We're going down the road. What was that? Boycott, ban swine stench from our streets. Mandus factory must close. Well, the amount of pigs and pig-related things I've seen, I'm not surprised. The factory's got its own church. Interesting. I've wrote something down and I found something else to read, so there's a lot of reading in this one. Holy orders. This church is connected to the plant. How odd. However, it does suggest another route into the main part of the facility, given the locked doors around the fueling station. The truck blocks my way, however, almost as if the saboteur knew that I might consider this alternative entrance. Ah, I see. The truck. That makes a great deal of sense, actually. So, this is blocking the way, is it? St. Dunstan's Church.
Whoa. Come on, Papa.
Whoa.
Let's climb this one. I can see more pictures at the top.
Kids, you son of a bitch. I give up, seriously. Yeah, anyway, St. Dunstan's Church. Oh, okay. So, that's probably why I need the fuel. Can I crank this up? Oh, I can, actually. It ain't not working. There's something missing here. I bet that's a fuel tank. That's about the same sort of shape as that thing back there. It probably is. Anyway. Delivery schedule. How in blazes are we supposed to meet these damned schedules? Even the basic equipment we are provided with simply will not perform its designated function. These cursed newfangled trucks will only run a fraction of the distance my old nag managed before running out of stinking gasoline. The gaffer says it's fine, and there's plenty of pumps to refill them outside the factory walls, but you end up dragging a blessed tank from the truck to the nearest one to refill it, and the one in the storeroom is empty again. I can't be turning that crank handle all day only to find the tank is empty. Well, sod it, says I. Enough for a night to go to my bed I go. It's not like anyone needs access to the bleeding graveyard anyway. Harry, if you get this, I'll meet you in the Damson Templar for a jar. Damson Templar. Okay, well. Alright, well, I think that's what I need to find. I need to find this. Fill it up. Get it going. I can't just, like, jump over it, can I? Oh, shit, maybe I can. I don't think so, no. And I can't go around it. No, I can't. Parked way too fucking close to the wall. Ah, well, alright. Bell Yard. Right. So, what is this? The meat processing factory, Mandus Co. Yeah, I know, 1828. It's been going for a while then. What we got in here then? Why is my lantern fucking about again? Chemical transportation, danger, highly corrosive, highly flammable. This is the tank, right? I think it is. A strange container. This canister looks as if it may fit the fuel pump I saw earlier. It certainly carries the same fetid, unholy reek. I will not think of that which I saw pass me in its cage. I will not gaze again into that dark machine room. A more immediate task presents itself, and the opportunity perhaps to gain access to St. Dunstan's. What the hell is he talking about? What am I missing? Well, now I'm curious. What's all this about? Oh, it's this diagram again. Apart from this part is lit up this time. I can't go down, unfortunately. Let's just take this container. Let's get it filled up. I'm sure that's what I'm meant to do. And then we can get this truck moving. Then we can go into the graveyard and follow my hallucinations some more. Oh, it fits perfectly. Right. Let's give this a go then. It's going down. I like that. Come on. Oh, shit. Fuck. Whoa. Oh, shit. There's something up there. Oh, man. That looked like a pig. I swear these fucking things are pig monsters. Let's just get this done. Is it trying to break open the fucking door next to me? Shit! Turn! 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 Get it all in! Okay! Go! 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 Shit! Run! Run, but read at the same time. A fast getaway. Dear sweet lord of all that is good and holy. I must make my escape, grasp this container and its putrid contents, and flee this place before that creature, that nearly man, returns. I will head for the church. Surely such an abomination could not follow into hallowed ground. Well, to be honest, I bet it could. So I should probably fucking pick this up and go. Run! Don't crouch on the ground. There's a pig mask there. Who the fuck put that there? Oh, okay. That's in. I probably need to crank the handle now. Let's pull this around. Yes! Okay, and it just instantly went into reverse. That makes no sense. Okay. I'm in. I'm going to lock myself in if possible. Whew, okay. So then.
This way, Papa. Come and see. Will it hatch? Can we take it home?
Yes, my darlings. Of course we can take it home.
There's a pig. What? Seriously? Did I make graves for pigs? Apparently. Oh, hell. Hell, shit. Is this one of the creatures? Ooh, I'm sort of glad I can't see it all. There's still a little bit of mystery. I can't really tell what it looks like yet. I've only seen silhouettes and shadows so far. Right, the kids went down here, I believe. But I'm more intrigued about what's through here. Nothing. Nothing at all, unfortunately. Uh-huh. What is this? Ooh, let's move. This is actually quite creepy, I've got to admit. Right. Kids, seriously, you've got some explaining to do, I think? Ah, okay. I'm going to cut the video here. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next part.